Oh my. Can you really? Well, first I want to say welcome to the Real Nelsons podcast, where we talk everything family, fitness, and relationships.
What is relationships, you might ask? It's friendships that turn into relationships, much like our marriage, right? You ain't gonna dab me up today?
Yeah, he irking me with this. So let's talk about this. This is not part of it. Tell us about your wonderful medal, babe.
Yeah. So today I just ran a 5K. This is the first 5K that I've run on purpose. Like, I feel like all the other 5Ks, like, Dawn be having, you have to, like, do the, like, the shoot the gun and start.
No one actually trips into a 5K.
And then I run. And so, like, I actually prepared for this one.
What place did you get?
I got 32nd.
Out of
337 people.
It's our first one.
305
now, I wasn't there for training. I wasn't there to coach him through it. It would have been, he's already told me some of the mistakes that I felt like he made. So next time it's going
to
be.
Yeah, no. My goal was to run 7:30, stay at 7:30, and I ran 7:22.
He really excited.
I'm like, so, I am really proud of myself. It's not many times I'm like,
You are right. This is all. Can I get to the.
I'm just going to warn people, like, the energy I'm going to get this episode is just proud of myself energy.
I think it's going to be a mixture because I feel like he's going to be high and then he might crash.
Nope. I'm proud of myself.
Okay.
Feeling myself.
So today's topic is mom roles versus dad roles. What? Now, let me be clear. Really, that topic is just to pull you in because I'm very clear on there are no mom roles or dad roles. There's only one thing that a dad cannot do, and that is breastfeed. Other than that, you in that thing with us.
The way things set up right now.
Nope.
So here's a fact, fun fact, not really a fun fact, but it's a messed up fact. In the United States, there is no federal paternity leave. So the government has left it up to states to decide. No, not even paternity, maternity leave. The government has decided, lets the states decide what the maternity leave is going to be. Now, WHO, the World Health Organization, has suggested that the minimum amount of maternity leave should be at least 16 weeks. Mm-hmm. But you know what it is in the United States? 12 weeks, right? And all maternity leave is verification that you won't lose your job for having a kid.
And so you said these 12 weeks, does that also apply to a man? You said the paternity as well, or just maternity?
It depends. Like, it's no law. I mean, you know what I'm saying?
All right.
And so, what's ironic though is in the UK, maternity leave can be at minimum 37 weeks and of pay. So you can be paid 37 weeks.
Jesus.
Maternity leave.
Amazing.
And up to 50 weeks unpaid. Right?
That's amazing.
That's crazy.
That's okay. Okay.
Yeah.
37. So, I'm trying to have another one and move to where?
The UK, United Kingdom.
Okay, we have another one. We're going to the UK.
Good night, mate.
Okay, something that we need to be clear is that you want to talk about this, how we're both new at this.
Yeah, so when we have kids.
Yep, because we have kids.
We've never had
kids.
I'm going
to be a lot during this episode because this.
Oh, you're trying to match my energy?
This topic burns me up.
It bothers me too.
I apologize if I jump in. Go ahead, baby.
The crazy thing about having kids is the fact that neither the mom or the dad have had kids before, right? When you have your first.
Yep.
And with that being said, we both knew Eddie,
mm-hmm.
right? And so I don't know if I'm jumping real fast, but moms are better at it out of necessity. Right?
Necessity. What does that mean? Because we were talking, when you said that, I was like, that is perfectly put.
So what that means is.
This right here needs to go viral. Moms are better at it because of necessity. And that means.
That means that mom is just left at home to do all the parenting work. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
I mean, there's. So. Traditions, and you're going to talk more about traditions, but, you know, because the father cannot birth the child, there's this not even
warped,
weird.
Warped sense of thinking.
Yeah, there's this warped thing where it's like, all right, she had the kid, I got to go back to work.
No. I thought you were going to say this warped thing of she had the kid, so she know what to do.
100%.
And it's like, no, that's the thing. We don't. Yeah. Like, literally once this baby came out, I'm like, hey, this is my first time seeing this baby too.
Yeah.
First time hearing this baby cry. This first time knowing that the baby's hungry, changing that. Like, there are so many things that us as mothers Okay, an example. Let's talk about the traditional roles. Traditional, right?
Yeah.
Okay, for the mom, it's called everything. Feeding, putting them to bed when they're fussy, soothing them, cleaning the house, cooking for everybody in the house.
Yeah.
Literally everything. And then when it comes to dad roles, it's pretty much helping the mom out and then bring home the bacon. Yeah. Now, my question with that, and if this is the part that I in the comments, please, like for real, help me understand maybe if this is how it is and you're okay with it. I've just had a lot of conversations with moms and they're like, true, I don't get it either. So if they're in the household, if there's an understanding that I'm going to stay home with the kid, I'm going to be the stay at home mom, and then you go to work and bring home the bacon, why once you come home and we're under the same roof, why don't we now share in the chores and the raising of our family? It's like you come home and because you were out all day working and oh my goodness, it was so hard, I'm still expected, because I was working all day too with your child. It's still expected that I clean, I cook for you that went to work, wait, for me, and then for the other kids possibly if we have them, why don't you come in and jump into this with me? We're both tired.
That's that weird gender role thing that's always been in place for forever, where the woman stays at home and takes care of the house. Yes. And taking care of the home is everything that's in the home. Mm-hmm. Now it's this new kid and the dad goes to work and goes home and eats the food that you cook.
Yep.
But I paid for it. You know what I
mean? Right, right.
This is weird.
So here's the other thing for me that really makes me like, okay, let me give you some more examples of how I'm confused on our thinking.
She is hot about this.
No, because.
Go ahead.
Because I can't. I'm in it.
Mm-hmm.
And I see how a mama can just be done. Like, we are so overwhelmed, done. But guess what? We can never be done because we still have this human being that is so helpless and we love so much and we would never not. So we just gonna do it and we're gonna do it and then find time to take care of ourselves and all this. Okay. So anyways, warp thinking. Another example, real talk. So moms and dads, just answer this for me. In the comments again, who takes the kids to all of their doctor's appointments?
Mm.
Who takes them to daycare, picks them up? Who does that?
Mm.
Okay. When you're running errands, is it kind of unheard of for the dad to take them? Like, yo, that's a lot to take the kid. Like, that's a lot. If we got two of them, you really doing the most to ask me. But for the mother, it is no question, no whatever. There was a dad, and I know he was joking, but it's an example of like, people really think this way. His joke was he had a contract to sign for his wife. And he's like, yo, if you want some time to yourself and you want me to leave the house with the kids, he's like, you know, 4 hours is my max. So you only give him 4 hours to yourself. And then we coming home because I don't know what else to do with him. But with us, we got to be gone all day. We running all the errands. We doing listen, it is so many things that we make look easy and it is not. And when y'all have it, y'all like, whoa, that's a lot. Y'all really want me to have a kid too?
So it's interesting though. So what's interesting is like the video you're referring to is the football season contract, right?
Yeah,
that's the backstory to it. But it is funny though, right? But what bothers me about the whole gender roles of parenting is whenever the dad has the kid or the dad is with the kid with their kid, he's babysitting. I cannot babysit my own kid.
Yep.
Right. The other thing that bothers me, because I understand the mother's perspective. What bothers me is how easy it is for a father to be praised for doing simple parenting things, right?
I take
Zoe and Harper to the grocery store. Oh, it's so sweet. It's a cute thing. It's great. If I do Harper's hair, like, oh man, if I make dinner,
yeah,
you know what I mean? Like, it's so easy for a father to be affirmed for being a father, but that's not reciprocated for mothers. And I think that, like, what that does is that wears the mom down.
It does.
Right? Now I'm not saying stop commending me for being dad. You know what I'm saying? Keep it coming. But what needs to happen, though, is mothers need to be appreciated, right?
Mm-hmm.
And now when I think about our relationship, and I think this trickles down to parenting.
Okay.
Right? In our relationship, we've always been attentive to each other, right? And so like at any time of the year or at any juncture in our relationship, it requires for Dawn to be all in, focused on me. Mm-hmm. And then there's certain times where I got to be focused in on you.
Yep.
And I'm making sure that you got everything you need,
right,
that you're supported and you're protected and everything mm-hmm. like that, right? And so now when you had Harper, like, same energy.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It was mm-hmm. like, all right. Like, I remember when we went to the hospital. It's like, I'm coming home with two people.
That's what he said. Yeah.
And so
that was such a powerful thing.
I was by that bed watching all the vitals, talking to the nurses. I'm looking at the bags,
making
sure the bags wasn't no blood and nothing or anything like that. And so, like, for me, like, I think that when it comes to parenting, especially on the father's side, you have to pay attention to the way that your relationship is. Mm-hmm. Like, and again, it could be some truth behind it. And I let's challenge it. Let's see what's up. Right. Does your husband or does your partner parent the same way that they take care of you in the relationship?
Is their parenting style mimicking?
Yeah. The relationship. Right.
Yeah.
Because I think that I think that's how we get down.
Yeah. No, we absolutely are all in. And I'm going to be honest. I don't know, it may sound crazy to say, I just don't think that I could have been with someone that wasn't all in. And with all the mistakes and all the perfection, like, we got it right, we got it wrong. Uh-oh, you know, got to make these changes. I just don't think that I could have been with someone that was 100% okay with kind of seeing me almost on the verge of falling apart. And then it's like, hey, babe, you know, take you a day. Then it's like, why did I have to get here? And it's funny because I'm like, let me say this because I feel like I was going so hard. I've already said, I was like, oh, I'm about to be lit up.
Yeah.
And I'm about to be lit up. Like, I'm very clear on, like,
she's not talking about our relationship. I wouldn't be doing that. Like,
oh, yeah,
you ain't get on here to just, you, like, come for me.
We wouldn't be. No. I'm saying this, and be very clear. I know it's not all dads. I have one in my household. Yeah. So I'm not coming for people like she. I do. What I'm not talking to you. So in the comment section, say, amen, sister. Like, I'm not, you know what I mean? I'm like, for me. So be clear. I'm talking about where the woman is very clear that she needs help.
She's
not feeling supported.
Yeah.
Or maybe it's vice versa. I mean, there are some situations, 100%. You know, where the father is like, I'm leading, and the mom just
that's stay-at-home dad.
They're absolutely stay-at-home dad. So let me say that.
This close to being a stay-at-home dad.
He was. He really, really wanted to be. He wanted to be. And so, but let me be clear. No, I don't think you would have. So let me be clear. Don't come for me, although you are, because you're like, sis, you done went like 20 some minutes in. We didn't know that you felt this way. Stop coming for me. Backspace out them comments. Because I'm like, there are men that also feel the same way that I do that also need that support.
Yeah.
So I know something you want to talk about was since the pandemic.
Yeah. So it's called the pandemic effect. Mm-hmm. And there was a Harvard study that basically said that after the pandemic or during the pandemic, mm-hmm. When we are all forced into our homes, into the safety of our homes, and everybody had to work from home, the father's interaction with the kids increased. And what that did was that I had to pull out my notes so I could make sure that I say it all right. Right. 70% of fathers appreciated their children more, which is interesting.
That is.
Right. They were more aware of their child's feelings. And they engage more with the children in their daily activities and in conversation. And as a result, it kind of influenced fathers. And I experience it right now as a teacher.
Yeah.
It influenced fathers to, like, really intentionally be more present.
Yeah.
Like, so much so where they're changing their jobs, or they're changing the responsibilities that they have in their jobs. There were coaches that were like, nah, I can't coach anymore because I want to be present for my kid.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Because when I read that study, I thought that was great, but I also thought about all of the years that this child didn't have this, like, fatherly influence or this fatherly interaction. And so, like, what I'll say is, fathers, keep it going, you know?
Yeah.
Keep showing your kids love and keep being present, because they need that.
They do. I mean, I was saying, I mean, I don't know if this goes with one podcast or the other podcast, but we were saying how you, like, for a lot of times, not all, a lot of times, the mother is a disciplinarian with, especially with the girls, right?
Oh, 100%.
And then when it comes to, you got something on your lip. And when it comes to boys, do you think the mother is a disciplinarian with the boys?
I don't think so. Okay. And it's one of those things where they can be, but it's not always, like, productive.
Mm-hmm.
right? It's not always productive. Mm-hmm. And the interesting thing is, like, I'm a disciplinarian to my girls, but I can only do so much. Like, last week, Harper got in trouble for...
it was hilarious.
She pottied on herself.
Playing. Just wouldn't stop playing.
And I took her... Yeah. She, like, Harper's like a all out. And I do everything else I need to do once I finish going all out. And so, like, went to the bathroom and she's like, you know, upset. And I told her, I was like, you can't keep doing this.
She went in the bathroom.
And, right? Like... That's it. And I left out and went to Don. I was like, I can't do that no more.
Listen, it wasn't. It's because I had never heard him try. It was clear that he was trying to really do, like, Harper, I am so disappointed in you. You can't do that. And I was like, okay. And I'm at the refrigerator. He comes around the corner and he did not make. He just walked straight to me. He was like, babe, I can't do that no more. I'm like, and the thing is, it's so funny. I was like, I got you, babe. Like, I knew what he was saying because he is very much a, like, Harper, don't. But that trying to crack down, your boy cracked. Like, it was,
my crack down can't, like, it's, yeah.
Yeah, no. But it's saying, though, I think it's important for kids to see from the opposite gender,
mm-hmm.
to hear and see them get correction from them because it teaches them how to accept, how to interpret, how to receive kind of correction from the other gender, right? Because if a dad is like, you know, I'm never gonna say nothing. I don't.
Yeah, no. If a dad, a girl dad like myself, tells our daughters no. He never says no. Then when she shows up in the world and she receives rejection, she's not gonna be able to, like, bounce back from it.
And it's extremely aggressive. It's way too much. It's like, why 100%. Would he talk to me like that? And
it can be
the guy just said, you're not my type, or no, I don't want to do that, or whatever.
Relationship, it could be in business or anything. No, like, whenever they experience, like, failure to some degree, like, you can take them out. And so we do have to be intentional on how
we show. And I think about it with boys, right? Hearing that from their moms, it shows in that a woman can be strong, can be stern, can, you know, say certain things, be assertive, and they're not being like, she a B-I-T-C-H. You know what I mean? All these things. Yeah. Like, no, that's just not correct. You know, so they see it as a, just like an equal type of thing.
Pause. I got a question for you. We didn't talk about this. So what if I don't have a feminine influence in my house, but I have a young girl? How do I deal with that? And what if I don't have a masculine, somebody with a masculine influence or a positive influence in my kid's life? Our dad or mom whatever present, what do we do?
So I think it's really important to, like, do you have people in women, the opposite gender, the gender of your child, right? Do you have someone that you trust in your life, someone that you maybe known for some years or just an amount of time that you feel comfortable with where you're like, they are a good person. I feel like they have good qualities. I feel like
their values match your parenting.
Exactly, you know? Yeah. And so just having them possibly to try and start a relationship, a bonding, you know, where maybe your child can talk to them about things, you know, especially when it comes to, you know, little girls, have another woman maybe to talk to about that time of the month. And there are definitely some relationships where the dad is all in and he's like, I'm comfortable. That's my daughter. I want her to talk to me. But maybe, you know, if the situation is not that, I think that, you know, and then we always say it takes a man to raise a man. That's what people say. Now, I know some women have done a dope job raising little young men.
It's
something about seeing another man, being a young boy, seeing another man doing the things that we feel a man should be doing, you know, like being a productive citizen, talking right.
It definitely hits different.
Yeah. So, like, I think that's a way to approach it. I mean, there's other ways. So y'all can tell us what other ways, because we're not in that situation. We have two girls, they got their mama and they have their father. So, you know, what are some other ways that,
because there's no end all to it. And there are some amazing moms that can hold that role and teach and raise strong young men.
Right. Yeah.
And vice versa.
We gonna do it.
Yeah.
That's one thing. Listen. What we not gonna do is let it slip through them cracks. We gonna get it done. Like, it just is what it is. We'll figure it out. We'll do our research. We'll learn along the way. We'll make whatever corrections we need to. It's gonna get done.
Which leads me to that last point.
Oh,
just like moms figure it out. I'll just think about it and then we'll wrap it all up. But, like, you gonna get it done, right?
Yeah.
Our second child, Zoe, like, it was a different experience, right? And she didn't breastfeed for how long did you breastfeed Harper? For, like, almost a year, right?
Harper's
breastfed for a year. Yeah. So we knew where the milk was coming from.
Yep.
Right? But for Zoe, we did something different. Yep. And so we had to make our own milk. Had this dope, we have this amazing recipe that we use, a vegan recipe. But like when we started it, Dawn did all the work, right? Dawn made the milk.
I did.
She was feeding her.
I did the research to find it. All of that
stuff. She did all of this stuff, all the legwork, right?
I was nervous. I was stressed.
And she was so good at it, right? That I was just like, oh, she's killing that.
Mm-hmm.
Until Dawn went out of town on business and I had both the girls and I had to make milk myself. And I was like, oh, this is pretty tedious.
Yeah.
Like, and so, but what it did was it showed me like, dang, bro, you've been slacking, right?
Okay.
It was like, okay. It showed me that how much more work mm-hmm. that you had been doing mm-hmm. that I wasn't even like, yeah. I wasn't even attentive to, or I didn't even recognize. And it took you leaving
yeah.
for me to get that. So then once you came back, I was intentional yeah. about, yo, I'll make some milk.
I was like, what is he doing?
Because he's
I got it. And I'm like, I could just, I got it. And I'm like, okay.
Yeah.
Once again, we so used to it, just getting it done.
Yeah.
So what you're saying, I would suggest possibly mm-hmm. Sometimes letting there be from whichever partner in the relationship feels like you do all of it. Sometimes don't loosen the reins. Let them things go. You go to the store, go to the do whatever, and don't take your
kids with
you.
That's what I was supposed
to say. I didn't know if he was getting to it.
No,
look, don't take them kids with you. Legit, listen.
Yeah,
and, look, and the thing, my thing, this is my thought.
Yeah.
You know they're going to be alive when you get home. They're going to figure out how to feed them. They're going to figure, like, and I'm talking about, for real, no, the reason why I said,
an example. Do what you're doing.
Okay.
Do what you're doing.
Typically when the parent that's at home with them that does everything, when the other partner leaves, they don't prepare the bottle. They don't lay out the clothes that they need to have. They don't say, oh, they take a bath around this time. Oh, they, right? So I'm talking about, look, and this sounds so crazy. This is when I get real, like, I'm talking about bounce. You'll find that milk. No, I'm just playing. No, you know what I'm saying? Like, just let them, they need to experience being a parent and feeling what you're feeling. I feel like this is so aggressive to say, to just say leave.
So then let me say it. All right. Now, hear me out.
I wish I would have let
this
you say
is for,
it. Because y'all going to come for me.
This
protect
is for,
me.
This is for the dads and for the moms. Forward. Right? But I'm talking. So listen. Hear me out. Let go, mom. Like, let go.
Or dad.
Dad, let go. Right? We kind of good at that. That's not hard for us. So, but moms, let go. Loosen the reins, right? Go get your nails done.
Mm-hmm.
Go shopping.
Yeah.
Go to the mall. Just go walking. Meet up with your girlfriends,
mm-hmm.
right? Leave the house.
Yeah.
Go for a walk.
Yep.
Join an aerobics class. That means that you got to do it weekly,
mm-hmm.
you know? And just focus on you.
Yeah.
You got to focus on you.
Yeah.
We'll figure it out.
Yep.
We're going to make sure those kids yep. are okay.
Yep.
But in order for you to be okay, you got to do those things. And so, like, as a yoga instructor, I always applaud my students because I know that when you come to a yoga class, you come in for yourself, yeah. right?
Yeah.
And oftentimes, 90% of the time, 99% of the time, we are everything to everybody for everything, right? Mm-hmm. And we only think about what we have to do for this person, yeah. what we have to do for this job, what we have to do next. We never dial back to see what's up with us. Or we wait till we see what else we have left. Mm-hmm. And oftentimes we don't have anything mm-hmm. left.
Nothing.
And you can't pour anything from an empty cup.
Yeah.
So basically what I'm saying is do what you need to do to fill your cup back up so that you can be what you need to be for everybody else.
Yeah. Agree. Are you done?
Yeah.
So listen, what you just had was the real talk from the real Nelsons. Okay. We just want to say seriously, thank you for listening. Thank you for tuning in. And don't forget to hit that like, comment, subscribe, and hit that notification button. Peace.